I can't find the light, and so now I'm in the dark in a bathroom in the Amana Colonies. So there's, but look at this. Look at this door. So that's a plus.
Please hang up and try again.
All right, guys, so here I am at the Amana Colonies. I'm in my car because it's raining a lot. I don't know if you can tell from my hat. It's significantly darker than it should be. So, it's not the greatest day ever because it's raining, but no matter, we trek on. All right, so the first restaurant I went to get breakfast, they said they stopped serving breakfast at 10:30. I got there at 10:33, so we had to scratch that. So now I'm at a different one to see, hopefully I can eat. They're very punctual here, definitely.
Sure enough, the Ox Yoke Inn was in fact still serving brunch. I got the buffet and it was spectacular. The peach juice was also phenomenal and it was complimentary. The next place I went to was the general store. And in that general store was the Christmas room, which evidently is ran year round, but for obvious reasons is very popular at this time of year.
I went to the visitor center, it's an unfortunate trend that has happened throughout this trip, is that it was closed. And so I will then tell you the history of the Amana Colonies. And that history begins in the 1700s in Germany. And just kind of to set the scene, this was a time where people were just kind of generally fed up with the Lutheran church, and so they were looking for other ways, other religions to believe in. And this religious group that would become this Amana religion, they were called inspirationalists. There was a community of true inspiration was what it was actually called. And they were, because they were not a, you know, mainstream religion by any means, they were oppressed and they were discriminated against. And in the 1840s, they decided they had enough of that. Europe wasn't doing very well. In the 1830s, there were wars, and then the next decade, there were droughts and just hard economic times. And again, these people felt really oppressed, and so they moved to the United States and they settled in what would become Ebenezer, New York, and they lived quite happily there, but they outgrew it, and so they had to find other places. And so in the 1850s, they sent a group to Iowa to kind of scout the land, see how it was, and 150 years later, they're still here, so evidently that was a successful trip. It's a very, very pretty town, and there's lots of history here, but it's also very touristy, which I think has kind of, I don't know what it was like in the 1930s or in the 1920s. I was not living, shocker, I know, but I think the fact that it's kind of changed into this profit sharing corporation probably helped that transition. With that said, there's still, from what I've read, is that the church and the community is still very important to these people, which was what really kind of brought them together in the first place back in the 1700s. So that continues. There's just more gift shops now. All right, guys, so I'm back at my hotel and I am pooped. So I am going to go to bed and wake up tomorrow morning for the last day of Choose My Adventure. Stay tuned for what the final day will bring.